So watching one of the captain's vlogs, Chris Boden, the Geek group, got a bit confused about using a audio video lead on an amplifier, and wondered why his connections were white and yellow instead of white and red. Jabroni was seemed a little confused. He just sort of said, well, that's the way it works. So I thought I'd do this video to come up with the reason why. And yeah, I don't understand why they do it either, but this is basically how it all works. The plug on the end is the AV lead was a TRRS 3.5mm jack, and the other end was I think the one they used was the one with the phono connections on, or RCA if you'd like to call them that, and I think they had adapters from phono to jack on the end of each. I'll go back to the start where we got mono jacks, and this is a basic mono jack from a long time ago. You can see it's nut and bolted in position on those contacts. You don't get that these days. It's a bit of plastic with sort of push fit connections, and they've got the mounting nut on the end, so you can put that through a panel. Now, obviously, when the jack goes in, the connections will make onto the positions. It's not quite screwed in properly, but if it was, they'd make on those connections there, as you can see. And that's the way it was for quite a while, I suppose. And someone decided that they now want a stereo version. So that was upgraded, and they managed to squeeze another connection in there. They made the actual body of the connector a bit different. Same pattern, but they managed to get more terminals in here. I'll show you a diagram of that in a moment. And on some of the jacks, they actually used the sleeve of the nut. It was metal. And sometimes that was used as the shield contact. This is probably a bit more of the professional nature, and as you can see, it's got a metal panel mount, and it's got the earthing or grounding tab on the side. This one's actually got switch connections inside it as well, but that's the basics. Yeah, they've got the metal sleeve as the grounding connection. So that's the quarter inch, and we'll start off with the mono. And as you can see, I represented the mounting plan for this black area. That would normally go through a panel, and on the side there you've got the ground. And I've put the nail there. That's just basically one connection for the end, for the tip. And this is a TS connector, so that's the tip and sleeve. Later, they managed to get rid of that sleeve for things like PC mount connectors. So that's what you get, and what you'll see there is a considerable gap between the two. Moving on to the stereo connector, you've got left, right and ground. So it's tip, ring and sleeve. That's what we call a TRS connector. These sort of connectors are used in other places as well. I've actually got one that's located, hang on a sec. that's actually a telephone jack, and that's TRRS as well. Bit different size than all 3.5 jacks. In fact, I think it's slightly bigger. Oh, it might be the same size. Might be slightly bigger than the standard quarter-inch jack. So yeah, this is very old. So it's not a new thing. So there we go. And then there's the stereo jack, and we've still got a bit of space at the top here where we can squeeze another terminal if we want to. And that's what they did. But for some reason, they changed the standard. So that is now the TRRS configuration, and what they've actually done is put the video next to the left channel in the ground, and they've moved the right channel onto the sleeve. Now, yeah, I know, that's weird, but that's the way that it is. And this is why, when you go from the stereo one, I'm getting both in view, your left and right from the jack now go into left and video, so that's white and yellow. And that's why on the video I mentioned that the phone is on the end. If you plug a stereo jack, if we plug the TRRS plug into a stereo output, like you'd get on the back of a computer, then you'd be using the white and the yellow as your left and right. And your ground is still in the same position as the other one. It's just that they've shifted the red up onto the sleeve here. That was part of the sleeve, and now the sleeve is shortened and they've made another ring. And this can cause all sorts of problems if you start mixing your plugs up, because you can get a mono plug and connect it into a stereo jack. And it's not so bad if this is an input socket. All you'll be doing is grounding the right channel, so you'll only get your left channel working. If this is an output and there's any sort of power behind it, then your right channel will be grounded, and effectively you'll be shorting your transistor outputs or whatever outputs there are in there. So that could cause a bit of overheating and damage. And if you ever get any equipment that's especially something like a PC or MP3 player maybe, where the right channel has gone wrong, then maybe someone has plugged in a mono jack to it. A bit more concerning, I suppose, is if you use that mono jack in an AV output. Your video and your right channel will be grounded. We can mix that up again and put a stereo plug into an AV output, and as you see there, your left will be okay, your video will be okay, but it will be on a red connector, and your right will be grounded because it shares the same sleeve. So yeah, that's it's not very nice if you get things wrong. As I say, especially if they're some sort of output. I'll put this up as a diagram on the website. Again, that'll be linked to below, along with a bit of description, a bit fuller description, and make your own mind up. Now, I'll just run through the types of TRS plugs. This is the, as I say, this is a TS plug. That's for mono, and would normally be used in a mono socket. You get your standard stereo. Again, all these are available in 3.5 and the 6mm or quarter inch jack, and that would go into essentially a stereo socket, and that's known as a TRS. That's the current 3.5mm stereo and 3.5mm mono. I haven't seen the AV in 2.5. I can't even remember if I've seen a stereo in 2.5, but certainly the mono ones are there. Normally they're used for remote control switch for tape recorders. Obviously you've got the ubiquitous PC cable, but this is the sort of lead that was used on that video. As you see, it's three connections for left, right and video, and this is the plug on the other end of it, and you can see there it's TRRS. So hopefully that sort of cleared up why the connectors don't look right when you're connecting one of these into the back of your PC, the TRRS plug to the back of your PC, and you get the white and the yellow as your outputs. So be a little bit careful. If you are going to put in something a bit odd, it's worth putting a resistor in series. I actually have a microphone on the computer from my headset, and so I put two resistors in there for left and right to sort of split the audio between the two channels. So I hope that's been a good insight for you, and explained why they changed this format compared to the stereo plug, where they changed the position of the right channel and swapped it with the video channel. But you know, we don't make the rules, we just have to use them. So there you go, that's the explanation.